This video is about solving the traveling salesperson problem. It is often abbreviated by TSP. As the name suggests, the problem involves a salesperson. This salesperson wants to visit several cities to do business there. And, of course, salespeople are always in a hurry. So they want to use the shortest route possible to visit all cities. We can think of the cities as nodes in a graph. Between any two cities, there is a road of a certain length. In the graph, the roads are represented by edges. One possible tour for the salesperson is shown here in green. It visits every city exactly once. The total length of the tour is 25. Please pause the video to see if you can find a shorter tour. In this example, there is actually a better solution. It's shown here in green and has length 24. Even though this problem seems simple, it is actually really difficult to solve. Finding the shortest tour in polynomial time is impossible. In other words, the problem is NP hard. So all is lost for the salesperson? Luckily not. Maybe we can still find a relatively short tour. For example, one that is at most 5 or 10% longer than the shortest one. In practice, such an approximate solution is often already enough. In the first part of this video, we will learn how to find approximate solutions for some cases of TSP. However, sometimes even approximating TSP is already really difficult. In the second part of the video, we will prove that approximating TSP is NP hard in general. First, let's look at a special case of the TSP problem, metric TSP. For this, we only consider graphs whose edges satisfy the triangle inequality. The triangle inequality is a very natural property that often holds, for example, when we work with distances between cities. It means that any two edges of a triangle are at least as long as the third edge. In other words, going directly from one city to another is never longer than taking a detour. For example, we can easily check that the triangle inequality holds for the blue triangle in the lower left. For metric TSP, we can find a tour approximation in polynomial time. That means, we can find a tour that is no longer than twice the shortest tour. How can we do this? We begin with a minimum spanning tree of the graph. The minimum spanning tree is the shortest possible tree that connects all nodes of the graph. In our example, the MSD has a length of 17. It is highlighted in yellow. Pause the video to check if this is really the shortest spanning tree. Also take a moment to think about why the MSD is always shorter than the shortest TSP tour. Let us understand why the MSD is always shorter than the shortest TSP tour. Removing any edge from the shortest tour leaves us with a spanning tree. And the minimum spanning tree is, by definition, at least as short as this. The minimum spanning tree can be found in polynomial time, for instance, by using Primes or Kruskal's algorithm. So how can we use the MSD to find a short tour? The surprising answer is that we simply travel around the MSD. This trip is twice as long as the MSD. However, this trip visits some cities more than once. But we can skip every city that has already been visited and go straight to the next city. Why does this give us a tour approximation? By following the minimum spanning tree, we use each of its edges twice. Skipping nodes only makes the trip shorter because the triangle inequality holds. And finally, as we already mentioned, the minimum spanning tree is shorter than the shortest tour. So, we have found a tour approximation for the metric TSP problem. Let's now go back to general graphs. Why can't we find a similar approximation here? We will show that it is very difficult to approximate TSP in general. More precisely, we prove that it is NP hard to approximate TSP to any constant factor C. A C approximation would find a tour that is at most C times as long as the shortest tour. So finding a tour that is at most 2 times as long as the shortest tour is not possible in polynomial time. The same is true for tours 10 times longer. Not even 1 million times longer is possible. For the proof, we use a reduction to a known NP hard problem. The Hamiltonian cycle problem. The reduction shows that, if we could approximate TSP in polynomial time, we can also do so for Hamiltonian cycle. But since Hamiltonian cycle is NP hard, no such algorithm exists. Hence, no polynomial time algorithm can exist for TSP. And therefore, see approximating TSP is NP hard. So what exactly is the Hamiltonian cycle problem? A Hamiltonian cycle is a tour that visits every node in a graph exactly once. You can see an example here in blue. The Hamiltonian cycle problem asks whether a Hamiltonian cycle exists in a given graph. Now let us look at the graph on the right. Is there a Hamiltonian cycle in it? Pause the video to think about this for a moment. In this graph, no Hamiltonian cycle exists. To do the reduction, we now transform the Hamiltonian cycle problem into a TSP approximation problem. We start with the original graph, for which we want to find a Hamiltonian cycle. From this, we construct a new graph with the same vertices. For every edge in the original graph, we add an edge of length 1 in the new graph. Furthermore, for every missing edge in the original graph, we add a long edge, of length c times n plus 1, to the new graph. Here n denotes the number of nodes in the graph, and c is our desired approximation quality. Now we apply the TSP approximation on the new graph and check if the result is longer than c times n. Pause the video to think about what this tells us about the original graph. Does a Hamiltonian cycle exist there? If the result is a cycle no longer than c times n, it uses only edges of length 1. These edges also exist in the original graph. So a Hamiltonian cycle exists in the original graph. On the other hand, imagine that the result is a cycle longer than c times n. Then no tour using only edges of length 1 can exist. Otherwise, this route would have length n and the c approximation would have found an result of at most c times n. But, if there is no tour with edges of length 1, then there is also no Hamiltonian cycle in the original graph. Hence, we can solve Hamiltonian cycle by approximating TSP. And since Hamiltonian cycle is NP hard, so is approximating TSP. This finishes the proof. So we now know that C approximating TSP is NP hard. But we could still hope to approximate TSP up to a factor that depends on N. Unfortunately, this is NP hard too. The proof shown in this video also works for any function f of n that can be computed in polynomial time. You can replay the proof to convince yourself. Let's quickly summarize what we've learned in this video. First, we looked at metric TSP, a special case of the TSP problem. For this, we were able to find a two approximation. On the other hand, for the TSP problem in general, we proved that it is impossible to only find an approximate solution in polynomial time. Thanks for watching this video.